Welcome to another episode of Times Square Kung Fu. I am your host, Frankie Balboa, aka Shogun Supreme. Y'all know the deal, you know the vibes. What are the vibes for today? I'm gonna show you guys how to back up your physical media. There's a question I've been getting a lot on Twitter and Instagram, and rightfully so, man. You definitely need to back up your physical stuff because anything could happen during a move, natural disaster, anything, you know what I'm saying? So, and also look, people don't feel comfortable. That I know, some of them feel comfortable buying a region-free Blu-ray player, and some people had a bad experience with them. So with getting a USB Blu-ray drive, I'm gonna recommend the one that I use and recommend it to others, and they have no issues with it, and they love it. But getting a USB Blu-ray drive for your laptop or PC, and if you do have a desktop, you could, you know, if you have room for an internal Blu-ray drive, even better, because you're gonna get faster speed having an internal one compared to the USB one, because the USB one is 8-speed, while the internal one is 16 speed. But if, let's say, you have a laptop and you want the speed of an internal one, you definitely need to get an external case that's USB, that's a USB 3.0, and you could actually put an internal Blu-ray drive in there and you get the same speed. That's something that I fumbled in my MakeMKV video. You're gonna hear me mention it. I didn't go into detail, but that's what I was trying to say. So yeah, you get an external, you know, enclosure case and put an internal Blu-ray drive in there, USB on your laptop or your desktop. I have like a mini ATX computer and I do have room to put an internal one, but I decided to put liquid cooling in that bad boy and, you know, I needed the room for the liquid cooling, you know what I'm saying? But with that said, you know, here's some clips on how to do these things, you know what I mean? You already know, man. I'll see you guys in a second. Peace. Alright, so right now the program you guys are seeing, like I mentioned in my intro clip, is MakeMKV beta. You know what I mean? And like I mentioned in my intro clip, you have to get beta keys every month or so. But I'm going to link you guys to a website where they constantly always update when the keys always drop. But I always slack off to get the lifetime license. I mean, I'm going to do that eventually. But for the ones that are tied on bills and everything, I'm going to link you to the website where to get the beta keys. So the reason I'm filming it like this, holding my phone, is because, you know, I tried to capture it, but the font was too small and everything. So I'd rather do it like this. So as you see, the disc is loaded up. Got the title and all that. So it's very simple. I'm going to press click and it's going to load up the disc. It's going to take like probably less than a minute or so. Wants to do this thing, man. But yeah, for a USB Blu-ray drive, it does its job, man. You know, like if I had an internal one, obviously it would be faster. But you know, I needed room for my freaking cooler, you know what I'm saying? So yeah. But yeah, you could get like an enclosed case and put an actual one for the internal one, and it'll be faster. I slacked off in getting one of those, but I'm happy with this one that I'm using right now, this USB Blu-ray drive. Alright, so as you see here, you see the film right here, you see the chapters, the different audios right here, and the subtitles, right? All these are the extras. All the extras right here. Now, usually I don't copy the extras, but for the ones that do, just leave that like that. And you're gonna get different video files for that. So of course you're gonna create a folder in your desktop, drag everything in there, name it the way you want to name it, like, oh, there's the extra for this and that, and that's that. But for this video, I'm just gonna capture the movie. But before I do anything, I'm definitely not saving that in my desktop. So I'm definitely gonna pick a different spot. Hold up. Okay, that looks good right there. All right, so I'm gonna save it on my F drive. So let's click away. Again, you know, because I have a big hard drive, pause. I usually don't compress the film. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't, just in case I wanna put it in a flash drive, watch it on my buddy's crib or not, you know? But for this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to compress it as well, you know, because it's good to know. So now here's the thing. So to keep this simple, man, DTHD, way more memory, less memory. That's all you need to know. This is uncompressed, and you know, and this one is semi uncompressed, put it like that. But yeah, and you got the subtitles right here. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna leave it like that. I'm gonna leave it all like that. All right. So now that we got this set up the way I want it, now it's time for the show, man. You know, we gotta press this little bad boy right here. And this usually takes like, with my PC and everything, it's gonna take like an hour or so. Like something like an hour or so. So once it's doing its thing, man, I'm gonna come back and show you how the file looks. All right, man? Peace. All right, we back. Now that the file is complete, you know, like I already have it set up over here, you know? So I'm not gonna play this because I'm trying to get, you know, copyright claim and all that stuff, man, but everything came out fine, trust me on this. And here you see the audio tracks. Like I told you, this is DTS HD. you know, master, regular DTS, and of course the English dub. Usually when you see stereo and it says English on it, that's the audio commentary, you feel me? So just keep that in mind. You know, you guys test it once everything is out. The file is it's pretty huge, man. It's like, you know, like 30 gigs or so. Well, actually, probably think is I think it's actually more than that. Truth be told, let me see. Let me double check here. Yeah, like 27 gigs or so. So yeah, so now that we got the file, you guys already saw how it looks. You know, once again, you know, you see the subtitles here. And the audio tracks. Again, once again, when you see stereo right there, is the audio commentary. So just keep that in mind, like I said. So now we have all this set up. Now to compress this 24, 27 gig file, you need to use another free program called Handbrake. You don't need any beta keys or none of that stuff already, you know? So let me pop up Handbrake. And there's the way it looks. I mean, you're gonna definitely, says it right there, just drop the MKV file there, you know? But before you do this, before you drop a file, I don't know how powerful you guys' computers are. Again, I'm gonna do an update video on this for Mac users, because I haven't ripped films with a Mac laptop yet, so I don't know how it is. But it should be almost the same point I hear from people. But what I'm getting at is that I don't know how powerful your computer is or your cooling system or whatnot, but this program uses the majority of your CPU. So let's say if it hits 100 and your computer turns off, to avoid that, you have to go on to Task Manager, right? This little bad boy right here. And hold up, it has to be this one. Here you go. You go to Details, right? And once you do that, you want to go to Set Affinity. And, you know, I turn four of these off, you know what I mean? Three. And it doesn't hit the limit of the computer, you know what I mean? And I could, you know, browse the web, listen to music, and the computer will be fine, you know what I'm saying? So just keep that in mind. It's the case if you're using the program, it turns off. Feel me? So let me show you guys how it looks once you drop this into MakeMKV, you know what I mean? So scanning, doing this thing, you know. Now, of course, you know, I want to keep this on a MKV format, you feel me? So let's go over here to video. Now, you always want to have constant frame rate, and also same as source. Feel me? Now, there's a slider that some people get confused about. And I mean, it's very self-intuitive. It tells you what it does. You know, as you see right there, I'll keep it there for a bit if you guys want to read it. But yeah, it's just like it's a quality slider, you know what I mean? Just like a video game, you know? But for Blu-rays, you know, to cut the nonsense, keep it at 22 or 23 to keep a nice size, you know what I'm saying? So for this, I'm gonna have it at 23. All right, and then for the audio, okay. Here's the thing. because this doesn't have a 7.1 track or 5.1, none of that. It's up to you. Usually me, I like to have it uncompressed and all that, but because this bad boy right here, when it's DTS HDMA, it's gonna take up a lot of room. So I'm gonna just choose regular DTS, and over here, I'm gonna go DTS pass-through. Now, if you don't want DTS and all that, and you're trying to keep the file size solid, because remember, DTS takes up a lot of room, like usually like 2 gigs DTS master, and this one is like less than a gig or so. So when you have something that's 5.1, usually people like to do to keep the file size solid, they go to AC3. That's basically Dolby Digital. And it keeps the file size smaller on the audio portion. Me personally, I just do DTS pass-through or the audio pass-through, and I need that audio. That's just me. But play with the audio, man, because there's a lot of flexibility in this program. Because if you choose AC3, for example, you know, you could go to 320, bump it up to 512 here and there. Again, some people can tell the difference from DTS master to, you know, Dolby Digital. You know what I'm saying? For me, I can't, you know. But yeah, if you guys want to keep the file size as small as possible, the audio takes up a lot of room. So, you know, AC3, you could do that and, you know, pick the bit rate, you know, 160, 192, 320, like everybody was going for back in the day with MP3s. So it sounds, you know, it sounds fine, you know, especially this shit is mono right here, you know. Me, like I said earlier, I'm going with DTS pass-through. I suggest DTS pass-through for people, but whatever, you know. Now, that's the original language. I love the dub, so I'm adding the dub as well. You know, so we're going to go right here. Boom. All right. You know, I like the commentary tracks. We go right here, add a new track. And boom, right? So here's the cool thing about this. Oh, let me do this DTS pass through. Me, I do just AC3. I'll leave it like that as a commentary. Now this thing right here is a drop down window. This is what's pretty cool about it. You could actually name the people who are doing audio commentary on this, you know? I forgot who's doing commentary on King Boxer. Let me double check here. Give me 1 second. Ah, there goes my bottle. And it's still rolling. All right, so we got David Desser doing the audio commentary. So all right. So there, yeah, so, you know, that's something to keep in mind. You know, I like to keep things organized and stuff, and, you know, it's pretty cool. So now that we have this set up, subtitles. All right, go with that. Take this off. You'll want it to be burned in, man. And I'll put it to default. Now, in case you guys are asking, why am I putting 2 subtitles here? Sometimes when you rip them, like, it doesn't pick the first one up, and some of it is what's it called, man? The one with audio description. So yeah. But yeah, I usually put 2 just to be safe, and I put the first one on default. Alright. See, the chapters are set up already. Yeah, everything's set up. Now, before, you know, I start, you know, compressing this, here's a tip. When a film has a lot of daylight scenes, it's going to be a big file. No matter what you do, it's going to be average from 7 to 9 to 10 gigs. So usually with those files, you know, for myself, I put it to 720p and it comes out to 3 to 4 gigs. You know, even if you take away the audio, like, you know, DTS or whatever, and you put it to AC3, it's still going to be huge, especially if it doesn't have the letterbox, you know, the widescreen, the black bars on top and bottom. So just keep that in mind. If a movie has a lot of night scenes, it's going to be a smaller file. So, you know, now that I have this set up, let me click in start encoding. I'll see you guys back. All right. Peace. Right. I'm back. the file is completed. And I forgot to mention this, when you compress a video, it takes longer than when you rip a video from Blu-ray. Like, you know, as you guys saw, that was like, not so, but basically, like I'm telling you, it was almost an hour. But when you compress it, it's gonna take some time. Took me close to 2 hours. Again, it's gonna be faster on other computers because I got an i7-3700K chip from 2013. So that, you know, that's almost 10 years old. So you most likely, if you have a newer chip, it's gonna be faster. But yeah, it takes time to compress, you know what I mean? So yeah, now that everything is set up and done, man, let me show you the size of the file now. Remember, this thing was a 28 gig file. So let's take a look now. All right. As you see, man, 4.8 gigs for 1080p, DTS audio. You know, I probably would have done AC3. It still would have been a little, you know, not that much of a difference, probably like 4.5, but it's not bad, man. And, you know, again, if you guys want to see screen caps, how it looks, I will definitely do that. I will link them to the description. But again, the audio is there and everything, you know what I'm saying? Let me show you an example so you can see what I mean. All right, real quick. Let me open VLC right here. All right, let me pause this. I ain't trying to, you know. Subtitles there, but let me show you the audio portion, what I mean. So yeah, as you see, you got the audio commentary there. You know, let me play that. You know, so yeah, so I like doing that when you use VLC player. Like, again, like I mentioned in the intro clip, man, VLC is the player to use. But also, I'm gonna do another video about Plex, because I usually have a Plex server running, and I get to watch it on my TVs or even when I'm away from the state and log into my Plex account and watch it, you know. Of course, anytime my computer running and everything. But yeah, there you go, man. 4.9, you know, gig 1080p file. Good audio and commentary there, you know. So yeah, man, hopefully the video was insightful, helpful. If you guys still have any more questions, man, you know, leave your questions in the comments and I get to y'all, you know what I mean. And I'm gonna wrap this up and give you guys my final thoughts. You already know. There you guys have it, man. I hope you guys found the video informative and intuitive as possible, man. Again, I'll be doing more videos like this. Like I mentioned, I'm definitely gonna do a Plex one, because Plex is very it's a useful an app where you could stream your films that you back up anywhere in the country, really. You know, you need your computer running, log into your Plex server, and let's say you go to California for a trip, if you don't live in California, but let's say you go to California on a trip, log in and stream your movies, man. I mean, you could do that. And yeah, and the great thing about Plex is, let's say you do not compress your films, you're even raw like I do now, because, you know, I have a big hard drive and I have two of them now. I have one 6 terabyte, another one 4 terabyte. So usually I'm leaving at 25 or 30 gigs, depends, you know, of course, obviously in the Blu-ray like you saw in that Kim Boxer one. And with Plex, you are able to choose the quality of the video to stream it anywhere from, you know, 20 MBs to 10. So yeah, you could definitely choose it, you know what I'm saying? So I mean, and still get an amazing quality and audio. I mean, damn, this thing could actually stream DTS master audio. So yeah, that's a good thing. Again, this is something you obviously need a good internet connection, you know, to use Plex at its fullest. But with that said, man, again, I kept the video simple. There's other programs I wanted to mention, but I didn't see the point. That's probably, I'll do an advanced video on that, especially in a program called MKV Tunix, which is an amazing program. It's free as well, but it's very advanced. But again, it wasn't necessary for this video because I was trying to get to the point, and these are the two major programs you need to back up your films, and if you want to compress them, You use Handbrake, like I mentioned, you know, an abundance of times, and as you guys saw in the video. So you already know, man. Until the next one, like, share, subscribe. You already know, man. Peace.